Good morning, everyone. This is Narada Rishi Raja with ExpeditiousFool.com, where we remove the obstacles. And today I have some more advice from the Gita. So let's get to it. We've got, let's pull it here. Spark of Splendor. So quite a bit going on that card. I'll let you look at that. And this is chapter 10, verse 41. It says, know that all beautiful, glorious, and mighty creations spring from but a spark of my splendor. So you can see here we have Krishna there playing the flute. We have Adi Shesha, which is one of Krishna's closest, I guess, friends, you could say. It's Adi Shesha makes up the exact substance in which Krishna lays on as he's thinking up the entire multiverse and the myth, the story, right? You see, he's got the flute there. That flute, that's a symbol of the vibration. So for instance, with the level of sadhana I've done to this point, in my ears, I constantly either have a high-pitched ringing or sound of water rushing. This is what they refer to as the Om sound. It's your friend. when you feel it, you know it's different than tinnitus or however you say that. You know, just a ringing in the ears. It's totally different than that. It's a friend. It's always there. It's a reminder. It's actually, technically, it's the sound of your nervous system when you develop your subtleties enough. But that nervous system resonates at the same spark of splendor, that same tone. Everything is made up of this vibration. And light, Einstein even proved that we are light slowed down. That's what we are. So we are vibration. Light is vibration, right? So we are light slowed down. We are just a vibration. We are just one of these songs. As this says, spark of splendor. And spark, of course, because light is the information, right? That's how you can concentrate vibration into information, is when it becomes light. So it's using spark. But when we're talking about vibration and using that musical analogy, it's a little bit easier to understand that. You could think of each thing in creation as a different note in this big, big song, right? Your entire existence is a note. Actually, it's probably just a portion of a note if we're being honest with putting it to scale, right? But it's just a note in this very, very long, beautiful, miraculous song. Right? So it's all just a spark of splendor. Everything's a spark of this big flame that is this all-existing God source, however you define it. You know, whether you call it Brahman, whether you call it God, whether you call it Jesus, whether you call it Allah, whether you call it Om, right? It doesn't matter. It's still all this big same flame, and we're all sparks of it. If we think we're anything else than that, that can create issues. If we think, well, I'm not a spark, I want to be something different, it's not going to work for you. You're not going to feel good. You're going to be always then searching for who you truly are. And who you truly are is that spark of splendor, of that eternal flame of Krishna, of Godhead, the Supreme Godhead, of God Source, however you want to define it. You're a spark of that. And so is everything else. Question is, are you acting accordingly? All right, everybody, have a great day on purpose and stay mindful. Namaskaram.